Today, friends, I'm going to show you how to use Tinkercad Sketch and a mirror trick so you can design faster. So let's get cracking. Today's trick is going to start with a template. Please type bit.ly/flip HL. When you do, it takes you to my Tinkercad template, which is, of course, set to copy in Tinker. So don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Give a reaction before you copy in Tinker. So friends, once you're in this project, we've got an SVG. It's pretty handy, but I want to show you why the sketch tool is even cooler. So I've got this pretty much in the center. We're going to take the sketch tool, and I want you to put it on a 20 by 20 spot. Notice the dotted line in the middle is right on the crosshairs of that. So then when we zoom out, you can see that this is lined up exactly on that shape. Now with the sketch tool, we're going to simply trace this as close as we can, being more interested in staying on the grid lines. So when I come up to this spot right here, notice I'm going to go up above, straight across, and come down. So it's as close as I can get, but also staying on the grid. So right here, I have to choose, do I want to be exact? Do I want to be short? Do I want to be past? Or do I want to set it to half? So that way I'm still in the middle and can get close. So I'm going to choose half for that one. Zoom out, zoom back down, make sure it's straight. Here I'm going to push in the middle mouse button and pan. Or use the keyboard shortcuts. Once again, making sure I'm straight up and down. I'm going to go below, keep it straight, do the half, across. I think I'm going to stay with the half right there. Once again, pan. Make sure I am going straight up and coming back down to middle. Now here's where it gets cool, friends. Instead of connecting, we're gonna hit escape and finish that shape. So it is 72 by 50. If these numbers are ever in your way, don't forget you can hide them just like this. Right now, we've gotta have them for the next part of this amazing trick though. Click on our shape. Notice clicking in the middle does not work. You need to click on the outside edge. And if we do Control C and Control V, we have instantly got a second one. I'm going to click on that second one and do Shift Nudge to move it to the other side. And then here's the cool thing, where it says 50, whatever dimension this is, just make it negative. And when you press Enter, bang, it flips. I'm going to bring this back to that middle. Notice it lines up perfectly. And we have just created the entire outside of this M. Now, the reason we did this is because now we can change the width. We can also add these cool rounded ends. So when we click on the other side, you'll see they connect better. I'm going to round both of those. And when we do finish sketch, we have now got the SVG, which does have outer line and inner line. But we've also got our new shape that smoothly goes all the way around this. Notice these edges right here. If we double click to re-edit, we can click on this and we can say, hey, I want that edge instead of sharp. I want it to be round. Bang, that corner just got rounded. I'm going to switch to the other one. And just because I want you to see both, I'm going to set this one to bevel. When we hit finish, it does look a little goofy because on this side they're rounded and on this side they are beveled, but at least that way you see how it works and it's so quick to go back in and adjust if you wanted it to be different. Once again, just hit the settings and I'm going to set them both to round. Notice I can also easily set that one to 4, switch to this one, set it to 4 as well, type the number, press enter, and when we hit finish sketch, bang! It is changed just like that. I'm going to set the outside to yellow. I'm going to set the inside to blue. And of course, find the right blue for Michigan blue, which I think would be right there. So friends, right there is why it's worthwhile to trace a design even after you brought it in as an SVG. All right, friends, so the main trick, of course, is if you draw half, you can flip it to complete your sketch. Now, I do also want to let you know, if you've never brought in an SVG for tracing, I've got a lot of tutorials. I'll put one of those up above if you need those steps. I do quickly want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget, there are 3 different levels of support, starting low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. Also, a huge shout out to all my supporters on Patreon. Love how that group is growing. We are past 200 members. Don't forget there is a fantastic messaging area where you can ask questions and learn about Tinkercad all in the same space. You can learn more about it with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.